गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, इन टुडेस टॉपिक वी विल डिस्कस सम इम्पॉर्टेंट पॉइंट्स ऑन द फोर्स एंड सम डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ फोर्सेस एक्टिंग ऑन द बॉडी। सो दिस इज द कंटिन्यूशन ऑफ द अवर लास्ट क्लास। सो वी नो दैट फोर्स इज ए pull or push according to Newton's second law, force equation, the net force acting on the body can be written as m into a, mass of the body. The force is acting, the net force is acting on the mass of the body, and a is the acceleration of the body. Here the SI units of force, SI unit of force is Newton. So generally Newton, capital N, the symbol is capital N. So we have one more unit, that is CGS unit. The CGS unit of force is dyne, and one dyne is equals to, see here, Newton, right? Newton is equals to mass, units is kg, mass unit is kg, acceleration unit is meter per second square. So that means 1 Newton is equals to 1 kg into meter per second square. So 1 Newton is equals to 1 kg into meter per second square. Like that, 1 dyne is equals to 1 gram into centimeter per second square. So gram centimeter per second square, that is equals to 1 gram is equals to 1 gram means 10 power minus 3 kg. Centimeter means 10 power minus 2 meters, that is equals to divided by second square. So here 10 power minus 2, 10 power minus 3, 10 power minus 3, minus 2 means 10 power minus 5 kg meter for second square. It implies 10 power minus 5 kg into meter for second square. Kg into meter for second square is nothing but 1 Newton. So that can be written as 1 Newton. That is equals to 1 dyne is equals to 1 dyne is equals to 1 dyne is equals to 10 power minus 5 newtons, or 1 newton is equals to, so 10 power minus 5, if you take in terms of dynes, then 1 newton is equals to 10 power 5 newtons, sorry, dynes. So 1 Newton is equals to 10 power 5 dynes. So this is the relation between dyne and Newton, the units of the forces. So these two units are important, so remember. Next one is, we have one more unit also. Of course, we have many units. So the important one is in British system. In British system, we will use the unit of force. The unit of force. The unit of force is pound. Pound. And the symbol is LB. So here 1 pound is equals to approximately it is 4.4 newtons. And pound is equal to how much? 4.4 newtons. Or you can write in this way also 1 lb. So this is the unit of the force, that is equals to 4.4 newtons. So this is also important conversion. Here lb, actually LB, the abbreviation of LB is Libra. So they are using this type of unit, pound, the symbol is LB. LB means Libra. So the meaning of Libra is, I think, balance. So balancing the scale. The meaning of Libra is balancing the scale. So in Roman words. Right. Next one is different type of forces acting on the bodies. Here in this chapter we will discuss the and we will solve the problems by using the free body diagram, and in this free body diagram we will use the different type of forces. So those different type of forces are acting on the given bodies. So here mainly we can divide these different type of forces into two category. One is contact force, another one is long range forces. So here it is contact force, here it is long range forces. So in case of long range forces and contact forces, see here, contact force means when a force is involving directly physical contact with the surrounding or among the bodies, then we call it as the contact force. That means there is a direct contact, direct physical contact between given two bodies. Suppose one object is at rest, and we are pushing this object in this direction. So we are pushing. When we are pushing, then we will use our hand. So our hand is also taken as the one body. Then this hand is applying the force on this body. That means there is a contact. So without touching, we cannot push this body. That's why there is a physical contact. So like that, examples of this type of forces. The first one you can say, any applied forces, directly any applied forces. Example, push or pull. Push or pull, or frictional forces. Frictional forces. We will discuss again frictional forces in details. Next one is normal forces. And one more is tension. So tension forces. Tension force, etc. This is the contact force. In contact force, what happens here? Two bodies are in physical contact. They are directly in physical contact. So those type of forces are called contact forces. So here we will discuss the these type of contact forces when you are solving the problems mainly. Those forces are applied forces or push or pull, frictional forces, normal forces, tension forces, and etc. We will discuss again one by one. Now coming to the next category, long range forces. What is meant by long range forces? A force that does not need any direct contact. It does not need any direct physical contact between the bodies. Those type of forces are called the long range forces. So here the force that does not require any physical contact. So these forces does not need the direct contact, direct physical contact. Example, yeah, you can take this example also. This is a planet Earth, and take satellite Moon. So here these two bodies are not in physical contact, but still there is a force between these two bodies. That force is gravitational force. So here Earth attracts the Moon, and similarly Moon is also attracting the Earth with the same amount of force in magnitude. So here the force between these two bodies is nothing but gravitational force. So in this case Earth is not in direct contact with Moon, but still the forces exist. So that example is gravitational force. Gravitational force. And you can take one more example also in terms of force. That means magnetic force. Yes, magnetic force is also comes under this category. Long magnetic force means it is not a example is, let us take a magnet here and one more magnet. This is this side is North Pole, this side is South Pole. So this side is South Pole, this side is North Pole. They are not in physical contact. Of course they are not at far distance, but they are not in physical contact. But still this magnet applies the force on this magnet. It will applies the forces on the second magnet. Second magnet is also applies the force on the first magnet. So there is a force between these two magnets, and these two magnets are not in physical contact. That's why magnetic force is also comes under this category. But here the point is, two magnets are located near to each other. They are not located far away. Coming to the next point, next example, you can take electric force is also, you can take the example electric force. Electric force means the force between two charges. Take one charge here And one more charge here. Let me take charge here is Q1. Here charge is Q2. So charge, this is charge. So in atomic level, we will discuss this different type of charges, like electron, proton. These are all called charges, charged particles. So here, the force between two charges, the force between two charges is also, there is no direct physical contact between these two charges, but still this charges attracts this charge, or it may repel this charge. That's why it is also comes under second category. Here the distance between two charges is very very small. So and etc. Right. Now we'll discuss individually these forces. The first one is normal force. So first one is normal force. Here normal force is the contact, one of the contact force that is perpendicular to the surface of the object which is contact on the surface. So here normal force, normal force is the component of a contact force, contact force that is which is perpendicular to the surface that an object contacts. That means this is the surface. On the surface, take one object is on the surface at rest position, and see here, this is the contact area. A object is placed on this contact surface. So this is the contact surface. So what is the meaning of normal force? When there is a contact between two bodies, here surface is one body and this is another body. This body is placed on the surface. There is a contact between these two bodies. And what is the normal force? Normal force is a component of the one of the contact force which is perpendicular to this surface. So perpendicular means you can draw a perpendicular line here with respect to this surface. So this is the simple normal force. This is the normal force. You can take one more example. This is horizontal plane. Suppose if you take an inclined plane, let us assume one body is placed on this inclined plane. Then what is the normal force here? Here normal, see, this is the contact area. This is the contact area. What is the perpendicular line? You can draw this is the perpendicular line for this contact area. Then this is the normal force. So normal force is always perpendicular to the contact area between the two bodies, to the surface and body. Now let me take one more diagram. Suppose this is wall and this is the body, and we are applying the force in this direction, pushing, so that the body can be at rest position, otherwise it will fall down. Right. Then what is the normal force here? To find the normal force, you need to find the contact surface. This is the contact surface. This part is contact surface. Now, what is the normal force here? This is the normal force. So, that is the normal force. Generally, normal force is always perpendicular to the contact area. Normal force is always perpendicular to the contact area. So here, let me take one more diagram. Here. Suppose this is wall, this is floor. A ladder is, this is ladder. This is a ladder. Nichena. You know very well, this is ladder. Nichena. Here, this ladder is supported by this wall as well as this floor also. Now, what is the normal force here? Can you guess? Right. Here, this is the contact area, contact surface. This is the normal force. So let me take here, this normal force is N. Of course, we have one more contact area here, contact surface. This normal force is also N. But let me take, this is N1, this is N2. So like that here. In case of ladder, so this is the ladder. This is the ladder. When the ladder is at rest position, rest means at equilibrium position, you can draw the two normal forces. So these are all the different diagrams, and the normal force on those bodies, acting on those bodies. Right. Next one is frictional force. So suppose this is floor and one object is at rest position on this floor. So initially at rest, and by using one wire we are pulling this object in this direction, in right side. So when you are pulling means indirectly we are applying some force. So here force applied in this direction. When you are applying the force, then the acceleration on the acceleration of the body is A, is also in the direction of the applied force according to Newton's second law. So this is the floor. This is the body. Right. As of now, we know the only force acting on the body, that is the normal force, that is perpendicular to the surface area. So this is surface, then perpendicular is normal here. Now next one, frictional force. Frictional force is also the component of the contact force, which is parallel to the surface. Normal force is perpendicular to the surface, but frictional force is parallel to the surface. So here frictional force is the component of a contact force that is parallel to the surface. That is parallel to the surface. That means, see, if this is the surface, the contact surface of this object with respect to the floor, then what is the parallel? Parallel means you can take this direction or this direction. Now here, the friction force is the component of the contact force which is parallel. So parallel component. This is parallel component. So frictional force we will represent with symbol small f. So this is the friction force. When you are pulling the body in this direction, then the friction force backward direction. The direction of the friction is friction force is opposite to the pulling force. So here friction force actually referring the force generated by the two forces actually. See, when there is a contact between this body and this surface, then only the friction force is generated. If there is no contact, then there is no friction force. When there is a contact, then only the friction force is generated. Of course, normal force also. Normal force is also generated when there is a contact. Similarly, friction force is also generated when there is a contact. If no contact, no friction force, no normal force. Then there is a contact, then friction force generated and normal force is also generated. So here friction force always, one more important point here, friction force always opposes the relative motion between the two surfaces that are in contact that means we are pulling in this direction, we are applying the force in the right side. What is the friction force? Left side. So friction force always opposes the relative motion between these two bodies. Relative motion means here surface is at rest and this body is moving right side, then friction force acts left side, so which is always opposes. Suppose if there is no relative motion, so if there is no relative motion, if there is no relative motion means you can say two bodies are at rest. Suppose if this body is at rest and this surface is also at rest, if both are at rest, that means no relative motion. When there is no relative motion, then there is no chance of getting the friction force. That's why there must be a relative motion. And one more important point is, here suppose same diagram, this is the normal force. Now let me pull this body in this direction. So that means F force applied. Then what is acceleration? This direction. So generally, we'll always give the direction of the force and acceleration. Right. Then body is moving in this direction because we are applying the force. Then what is the friction force direction? Friction force direction is this side. Because we are applying the force in this direction, friction force opposes. That's why this is backward. I mean, this is left side, this is right side. And one important point is, angle between normal force and friction force is always 90. See here, the angle between these two forces is always 90. So, and suppose so suppose if you are applying the force in this direction, friction force is backward. If it is left side, this is right side. Normal force is okay. Now coming to the one more diagram. Suppose if you are pushing the body. Pushing means let me push this body in this direction. Like this direction. What is acceleration? That means you are applying the force in this direction. We are pushing, see, we are pushing in this direction, pushing. Then what is the applied force direction? This is applied force direction. What is the acceleration direction? Same. Then, in this case, what is the frictional force? When you are applying this direction force, then the friction force is opposite to the applied force. What is the normal force? Normal force is always as it is, perpendicular to the surface area. Like this. Take one more example. Suppose this is an object which is already in motion. Already is, the object is moving, but this object is coming into rest. Coming into rest position. That means we can say velocity is decreasing. Velocity is decreasing. Velocity is decreasing means, suppose initially if the body is moving in this direction, this is the direction of the motion of the body, and now we want to stop this body so that we are applying the force and the body is coming into rest after traveling certain distance. Now let me take here, it is traveling certain distance from this point to this point. That means the body is not stopped suddenly. We are applying force here to oppose, to stop this body. We are applying this force. This is the direction of the body initially. It is moving with some velocity, but we want to stop the body so that we are applying the force in this opposite direction. Of course, because of the friction also, the body comes into rest. So, then, when it is coming into rest, then what is the normal force? So, finally, here it is moving and coming into rest. Finally, it reaches at rest position. So, this is the rest position. What is the normal force? This is the normal force. What is the friction force here? So, what is the friction force direction? So this is the, you think yourself and try to find the answer. Next point. The next point is, the important point is, here normal force is always perpendicular to the surface area and the friction force is always parallel to the contact surface area. So that's why you can take friction force is the tangential force. Tangential force between the contact surface. And the normal force is, it is a normal force between the contact surface. See here, normal force is, this is a normal component, this is tangential component. So sometimes you may get confusion with these words. Tangential means this is tangential, normal means this one, according to the diagram. Right, next one is tension. So tension, generally if you take a wire and one end is attached here, other end is one mass is attached here. I mean two ends are actually fixed. So this is mass. Now when the mass is attached to this wire, you can take wire or string or rope, whatever it is. So let me take, this is wire. So for this wire, the free end is attached with mass. Then the force arises in this wire. The force is called tension force, which is a pulling force. A pulling force exerted by a wire, comma, rope or string, whatever it is, cable, etc., on an object. So that is nothing but, see here, this wire is applying the force. Which type of force? Pulling force. Pulling means this direction. So this is the tension force. So because of the tension force, the body is hanging. Here, here tension force is always constant between these two points. Like suppose you cannot say that tension at this point and the tension at this point and the tension at this point is different. So tension between these two fixed end is always constant. That means I can say tension will remain, tension will remain constant throughout the length of the rope, throughout the length of the wire between two fixed points. Two fixed point. Now we will take one more diagram. Suppose this is floor and this is the body and the mass of the body is m. Now we are pulling this body by using one wire, so we are pulling. We are pulling this direction. Then what is the tension? So this is the tension direction. And if you are all, if you are pulling this body in this direction, at the same time this mass is also pulls backward direction. Now you can define tension in this way also. If you are pulling this mass is also apply the same amount of force in reverse direction according to Newton's third law. According to Newton's third law, if you are applying the force, or if you are pulling, the wire is pulling, I mean we are pulling actually, then the tension direction is this, tension direction is this, I mean right side. Then what about the mass? Mass can also apply the force on our hand when you are pulling, and the tension in this wire is T, which is backward direction. That means from this point to this point, tension is same. With respect to reference point, we will give the direction of the tension. Suppose if you say, if you are pulling this body in this direction, the tension you can write here T. If the mass is pulling your hand, then you can write the tension in backward direction. So that's why when you are solving the problem, you need to take care of the force direction, tension force direction. According to diagram, you need to draw the tension force diagram. So when you are solving the problem, I will explain in detail how to write the tension force direction when you are solving the different types of problems. Let me take one more example here. Suppose two persons, one person is standing here and he is pulling one rope. So this is the wire, and another person is standing other side, and he is also pulling the wire. Both are pulling the wire. When both are pulling the wire, then what about the tension direction? Both are pulling towards their position. Then what is the tension direction? Here, tension direction according to his person, according to first person, this is the tension. Because he is pulling this body, I mean this direction. When he is pulling, then this is the tension direction. Between this point and this point, tension magnitude is same. But with respect to the reference point, tension direction changes. So this is the tension. And one last point in this tension force is, tension force is always a pulling force. Tension force is always a pulling force. Tension force is always a pulling force, because pulling force is transmitting the force along the length of the wire. So that's why you can say it is a pulling force. You cannot say it is a pushing force. Yes, you can write here. I forgot to mention, normal force is a pushing force. Yes, you can write one more point here. Normal force is always taken as a pushing force. So this is a very important point. This is pushing force, this one is pulling force. The last one is weight. So weight. Actually, weight is nothing but gravitational force, which is pulled by the gravity. So weight of a body is nothing but gravitational force. So weight. Of a body is the gravitational force. So it is actually gravitational force. Gravitational force, which is pulled by the gravity. So any massy body possesses the gravity. That gravity is also pulling the another masses, remaining masses. So that's why the pulling due to gravity, that is called the pulling due to gravity. The force due to pulling of the gravity is nothing but weight. So you know very well the Newton's apple falling experiment. So the apple is falling towards the earth because the earth gravity is pulling the apple. That's why it is falling down. Right. So here, let me take this is the earth. Earth, and this is the center of the earth, so it is in a spherical shape. Now one mass. So this is the a object. Not exactly on the surface, which is situated at some certain height. Now what happens here? The gravity of the earth. The gravity of the earth. Gravity is always attracts the masses. I mean, the gravity due to earth, not only earth, in this whole universe, gravity always attracts the masses. So, gravity of the earth attracts this body, this mass. That's why it moves toward the center of the earth. If this is the center of the earth, it moves toward the center of the earth. And finally, it falls down on the surface of the earth. Now, the gravitational force of the body, the gravitational force of the body is nothing but weight. So, this is the weight, W. Generally, we represent with W. So, W is nothing but gravitational force. So according to Newton's law, we know that force is equals to what is the formula? Generally m into a. But this a acceleration, because of the acceleration due to gravity, it is falling down. So that's why you can replace with a with g, because here a is acceleration. Here the acceleration, which acceleration is acting on this mass? This, the acceleration due to gravity. So that's why you can write weight of this mass is equals to how much? M into g. So this is the formula of the weight, and the weight is a force. So that's why force is a vector quantity. Force is a vector quantity means weight is also a vector quantity. So direction is always towards the center of the earth. And moreover, this is mass and this is weight. So in most of the time we will get confused between mass and weight. So generally in our daily uses, in daily life, we will use these two terms without knowing the actual meaning. So all of you calculate the weight of your own mass. Suppose my mass m is around 65 kg. Then what is my weight? My weight is how much? M into G. It implies weight is equals to 65 into G. G is equals to 9.8 on the earth. So that is equals to 69.8 means I can take 9.8 is approximately 10. So that means 65 into 10. That is equal to how much? 650. So this is weight. My weight on the earth is how much? 650 newtons. See, mass is in terms of kg and weight is in terms of 650. So in supermarkets we will buy the groceries, rice, like rice, dal, chicken, whatever it is, vegetables, in terms of kgs, not the newtons. We will buy the 1 kg of chicken. That means we are buying actually mass of the chicken, not the weight. So this is the difference between mass and weight. So and moreover, one important point is mass is always constant in this universe, but weight changes. Because why weight changing here? Because see, if G changes, weight changes. What about mass? Mass remains constant. Suppose my weight on this earth is 650 newtons. What about moon? On the moon, my weight is W is equal to M into G. So 65 into G means we need to substitute the G value of the moon. So then we will get the weight. So which is around 1.6. So which is less than the G due to gravity. I mean G due to Earth. Now, one free body diagram. Free body diagram means, suppose observe here. This is a wire and one mass is hanged, the object. What is the meaning of free body diagram? A free body diagram in which we will write force component, all type of force component, and the mass and acceleration direction, mostly acceleration direction and forces. Here, how many forces are acting when the body is hanging? One is tension force, because wire is pulling the mass, this mass, and mass of the object is M. And this is simply hanging, just hanging. When it is hanging, then what is acceleration? The body is not moving, then the acceleration is zero. And other than the intention, is there any forces acting on this body? Yes, one force is acting, that is weight. That is equal to how much? M into G. Now, according to Newton's second law, net force acting on the body is equals to mass of the body and its acceleration. Right, fine. Now, here, net force means how many forces are acting? One is tension, another one is weight. Two forces are acting. And tension is upward, let me take positive, and weight is downward, let me take negative. So the net force is nothing but two forces. The sum of the two forces. Sum of the two forces means one force is acting upward, one force is acting downward. Tension is upward, weight is downward. So when it is acting upward, take positive. When it is acting downward, take negative. With respect to mass position, that is equals to m into acceleration. What is acceleration? Zero. Because which is at rest. Rest means acceleration is zero. Now, tension minus weight is equal to zero. That means tension is equal to W. So tension is equal to, right. So tension minus W is equal to 0. That means tension is equal to W. Tension is equal to weight, W. Weight value is how much actually here? M into G. So here tension is equal to how much? In this diagram, tension is equal to mass into M into G. Right. Take one more example. A body is falling. Simply falling body. Just body is falling. So this is the mass of the body, M, which is falling down. Falling down means the body moving in this direction. Body is moving downward direction because of the attraction due to earth. That's why the acceleration is downward, and that acceleration on this body is how much? Because of the earth gravity, it is moving downward. So the acceleration is downward. G value is always acts downward. Right. How many forces are acting on this body now? So the forces acting on the body is, one is weight, and that weight value is how much? M into G. What about tension here? No tension, because here there is no wire, nobody is pulling this body, earth is pulling. That's why we are writing the force W is equal to mg downward. Can you write a normal force here? Cannot write. Mostly we won't write, because this body is not in physical contact with the earth surface or any surface. So that's why we are not writing the normal force and the tension force in this diagram. Now, right, we want to calculate the net force acting on the body according to Newton's second law. Same law you can apply. The net force on this body is equal to how much? According to Newton's second law, M into A. Now, the net force, only one force is acting, that is W, M, A. So W is equals to M into A. A means how much energy? So that means W is equals to M into G. So here also weight is how much? M into G. Here also weight is equals to M into G. But that weight is equals to how much? Tension. Here also weight is how much? M into G. So that is the weight. And finally, let me give one diagram. Suppose this is the surface and this is the mass M, and this body is moving in this direction because we are pulling this body by using some force, F, applied force, by using this wire. So let me take, this is the wire. Yeah, this is the wire. We are pulling in this direction. We are pulling. So that the acceleration of the body is this direction. Now tell me, how many forces are acting on this body? Now the number of forces acting on the body is, one is normal force is always perpendicular to the surface. Another one is weight, that is equal to how much? M into G. And because this is contacted with surface, so one force is acting backward. What is that? Friction force. And you can take one force here, that is the force in the wire is tension. So like that, you need to give the all force components in the diagram. So this is called free body diagram. A free body diagram. In free body diagram, we will give all forces acting. We will mention all forces acting on this body and acceleration also. So and mass. So here normal, friction, weight and tension, and you are applied like that. You can write the free body diagram. You can draw the free body diagram for the mass which is moving in this direction. So now in next class we will discuss some problems based on this free body, based on these forces that we discussed today. Thank you.